गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
या गुड आफ्टरनून। सो वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू टुडे फ्रॉम द टॉपिक नॉन आइसोट्रॉपिक बट सिमिलर पॉइंट सोर्सेस ऑफ एंड देन वी आर गोइंग टू सी द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ पैटर्न मल्टीप्लिकेशन। सो वी विल जस्ट वी हैव स्टडीड द आइसोट्रॉपिक सोर्सेस एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड फ्यू थिंग्स अबाउट नॉन आइसोट्रॉपिक सोर्सेस and we are also going to see that how the pattern multiplication can be defined and what do you mean by pattern multiplication. So it's very easy to understand, so you can just make a note of it, non-isotropic point sources of similar non-isotropic but similar point sources and principle of pattern multiplication. So what do you mean by pattern multiplication? And if you are having two pattern like you multiply 5 and 3, similarly you have two patterns, so when you multiply those two patterns, how the new pattern will get generated, that's what you're going to see here. So in here the sources are non-isotropic. We are going to consider the source to be non-isotropic. Before, till we have been doing isotropic sources, we have taken isotropic source, we have taken that it is having more efficiency and all, as well as we have also seen that the isotropic sources, one isotropic source or two isotropic source of same amplitude, same phase, same amplitude, opposite phase, as well as quadrature phase shift, all these things has been talked about the isotropic sources. Here we are going to discuss about the non-isotropic but similar sources. Okay, so similar is used to indicate that the variation of the absolute angle phi of both the amplitude and phase of the field is same. So what you are going to see here is the indicate that the variation with the absolute angle phi of both amplitude and phase of the field is same, and the non-isotropic means that the separation of isotropic field with an electric field of individual sources, source field. So what do you mean by non-isotropic? So till now we have been studying about isotropic, where you have seen that the amplitude and phase of the fields are either same, or you can also consider two isotropic sources with different cases we have discussed before. But what do you mean by non-isotropic? It means that the superimposition of isotropic fields with electric field of individual source field. So so that is called as non-isotropic, means the superposition of isotropic field with an electric field of individual source field. So when you have a isotropic superposition of isotropic field with the electric field of individual source, then we call it as a non-isotropic source. Okay, here we can see that the maximum amplitude of the individual sources may be unequal. So this is also one more thing what you have to understand, the maximum amplitude of individual sources may be unequal. So you can see that the maximum amplitude of individual sources are unequal, and if they are equal, the sources are not only really similar. What we have to consider here is we are going to talk about the non-isotropic. So what do you mean by non-isotropic is you are having a superposition of isotropic fields with an electric field of individual source fields, and here the maximum amplitude of the individual source may be unequal. So it the maximum amplitude what you are going to consider for the individual source, it may be unequal, and if it is equal, the source are not only similar but are identical to each other. So that is what we can say here. You can make a note of these points. We are going to talk about the non-isotropic point sources. So we are going to see that isotropic fields are superposition of the isotropic field with the electric field of individual sources is called as the non-isotropic source, and the maximum amplitude we will be having amplitude for each source. So when you are taking the maximum amplitude of the individual source may be unequal. So it may not be the same. So we have also seen that in different cases that equal amplitude, unequal amplitude and all those things. So the maximum amplitude of the individual sources may be unequal, but if the case that equal sources, if they are equal, if the amplitudes are equal, then the sources are not only similar, you can say that it is also identical to each other. So that is what we are going to see. You can make a note of these points and then we'll move on further. So non-isotropic but similar point sources and the principle of pattern multiplication. We will also discuss about the principle of pattern multiplication further. So what you have already studied a few equations for pattern and we have gone through the different cases as well. So we have seen various equations when the isotropic sources are equal, amplitude and phase and all those things. So we are going to use some of the equations what we have studied before and we are going to just simplify that and then we will discuss the definition for pattern multiplication and how that can be represented using an equation, and also we'll discuss on some of the examples of pattern multiplication in this class. So we can see that, so all this comes under CO4 where you are going to understand about the isotropic sources, its properties and how it can be represented, two isotropic sources, n isotropic point sources and all those things. So let me just go to that later, and first we will understand that the equation, how it can be represented, which we have already discussed before, that is E is equal to 2E naught cos of psi by 2. So E can be represented as 2E naught cos of psi by 2. So 2E naught, I have 2E naught is the amplitude, you know that, and E is represented as 2E naught cos of psi by 2. These equations we have already discussed before as well. So E naught is E dash sin psi, sin phi, and when we substitute E naught, you get the above equation can be rewritten as E is equal to 2E naught dash sin phi cos psi by 2. So in for the normalized process, we know that the amplitude 2E naught dash can be written as 1. So the field pattern of the array is when we substitute 2E naught dash is equal to 1, you can write E is equal to sin phi cos psi by 2. So you can make a note of all these equations. So we have considered E is equal to 2E naught sin psi by 2, and E naught is E naught dash sin phi, and when we substitute E naught dash sin phi in place of E naught, you get it as E is equal to 2E naught dash sin phi cos psi by 2. The normalized, when normalizing, we know that 2E naught dash can be written as 1. So what you will get, E is equal to sin phi cos psi by 2. So you are going to get E is equal to sin phi cos psi by 2. So we have already discussed about the equation psi. So we know that we have psi. Psi can be written as dr cos phi plus delta. Delta is the phase difference. So you have already gone through this equation. Psi is equal to dr cos phi plus delta. So we can we have the equation E is equal to sin phi cos psi by 2. So psi is dr cos phi plus delta. So let us see that. So these are a few equations for you to understand. So finally, when we normalize the thing, 2 E naught dash is equal to 1, and we have received, we have got the equation for E as sin phi cos psi by 2. And psi is also known to you, that is dr cos phi plus delta, which we have studied in the previous class. So we also have the equation for dr as well. If we want, we can use that 2 pi d by lambda, and d can be calculated, and we can find out dr as well. So this equations can be simplified as and when you are doing any applications to go with. So the electric field, that is E, is produced product of the pattern of individual sources. That is, you can say that the electric field E is the product of the pattern of individual sources. What all things you can see here? Sin phi and cos psi by 2. So individual sources, sin phi, by the pattern of two isotropic sources, cos psi by 2. So you can see that the electric field E is the product of pattern of two individual sources, of the individual sources sin phi, and the pattern of two isotropic point sources, cos psi by 2. Psi also, you know that dr cos phi plus delta. So E can be written as sin phi cos psi by 2. Can understand these things, and let us continue further. The similar, if similar but unequal point sources we are considering, that is case 5. So we have seen that case 5 is the general case where you are considering two isotropic point sources of unequal phase or and unequal amplitude. So it is not even phase is same or amplitude is same. So we call it as a most general case where if the similar but unequal point sources are there, like in case 5, have pattern as given by the total normalized pattern. So you can rewrite this equation as E is equal to sin phi root of 1 plus a cos psi square whole square plus a square sin sin square psi. So this is what you are going to get. We are now going to define the pattern multiplication. Before that, you can make these things, you can note down these equations, and then we will go with the principle of pattern multiplication, what pattern multiplication talks about. Okay. So multiplication itself indicates that it is the product of two things. So here in pattern multiplication, it indicates that you are taking two patterns and then you are going to multiply and find out the what is the new pattern that is going to be generated. So that is what you are going to see here, principle of pattern multiplication. So let me just take you through that. So is that clear for you till here? We will continue with the pattern multiplication. Is that clear for all of you? Have you completed till here the equation for E?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we will continue further. So we'll try to understand what do you mean by pattern multiplication. So pattern multiplication, so principle of pattern multiplication is the total field pattern. So understand carefully, the total field pattern of an array of non-isotropic but similar sources. So what you are going to take here, pattern multiplication means, principle of pattern multiplication is the total field pattern. So the total field pattern what you are going to find of an array of non-isotropic but similar sources is the product of individual source pattern. So you have to take the product of individual source pattern, and you have to go ahead with and the pattern of an array of isotropic point sources, each located at a at the phase center of the individual source. So this is the definition for that, which is having the same relative amplitude phase component, while the total phase pattern is the sum of the phase pattern of the individual source and array of isotropic sources. So what does that indicate is, let me just explain you. So pattern multiplication of the non-isotropic array of non-isotropic point source means, the total field pattern of an array of non-isotropic but similar source means, you have to take the product of individual source pattern. So you have to take the product of individual source pattern. So if you are having like 2 to 3 isotropic sources, you will be having different source patterns. So what you have to take is, you have to take the product of individual pattern and the pattern of the array of isotropic point sources. So we have already defined there, you have to take the multiplication of array of isotropic point sources as well as the individual source pattern. So individual source pattern has to be multiplied by the pattern of array of isotropic sources, which is located at a phase center of the individual source and having the same relative amplitude and phase. So it will have the same amplitude as well as phase, while the total phase pattern is, you have talked about the now we are going to talk about the phase part of it. So the total phase pattern can be calculated by is the sum of the phase pattern of the individual source and the array of isotropic sources. So it will be very clear here. When you are going to take the field pattern, you can see that in the equation it is clearly mentioned here, f of theta phi multiplied by f of theta phi. One is small letter f and another is capital letter f. That is the, you are going to multiply the fields of individual pattern. But when it comes to the phase, you have to add those phase, like the f of theta phi plus capital F of theta phi, that is phase part of it. So field you are going to multiply and phase you are going to add. That is what it is explained in this definition for our principle for pattern multiplication. You can make a note of it. Then we will proceed further. So what you are going to do here is, you have seen that we are going to find the field pattern multiplication, you are going to find the total field pattern. So when you are going to take the total field pattern of an array of non-isotropic but similar source, what you have to understand here is, you are going to take the product of individual source pattern with the array of isotropic sources. So we are going to multiply those things, and when it comes to the phase part of it, you have to add the phase of those things. So we have seen that E is equal to f of f of individual pattern and the f of theta phi and f of capital F of theta phi, that is array of isotropic point sources, as well as the field. When you take, you have to add the fields. So you can complete it. So it is just you have to understand that when you talk about the pattern multiplication, you have to be very precise with the field and phase. And when you go with the field pattern, you have to go for pure multiplication. And when you go with the phase pattern, you have to go for the addition of the phase. Okay. So that is, in short, you can say that what you understand about the pattern multiplication. And when you are having a pattern and you multiply, we will see some examples where you multiply both the patterns and how the field pattern of the which will get generated when you multiply the both the fields. So you can complete this definition part of it. So f of theta phi, what you are going to get, the equation is f of theta phi, capital F of theta phi angle get added, that is fp theta phi plus capital fp theta phi. So fields will get multiplied and phase will get added. F of theta phi is called as the field pattern of individual source, and fp theta phi is called as the phase pattern of individual source. Capital F of theta phi, you can say that capital F of theta phi is the field pattern of array of isotropic sources, and capital fp of theta phi is field pattern of phase pattern of array of isotropic point sources. So this is the in short definition for the pattern multiplication. So the equation has been put in words in the above, and you can see that what individually it is. So we are going to multiply the individual field pattern of the individual source with its with the field pattern of the isotropic source, as well as we are going to add the phase pattern of the individual source with the phase pattern of array of isotropic sources. So that is what you are going to do it here. So it has been represented by using the equation E is equal to F of theta phi, capital F of theta phi, angle F of FP of theta phi plus capital FP of theta phi. So you get this portion is called as a field pattern and this portion is called as the phase pattern. So we can, you can all write this, you can make a note of these things. So we are taking individual source field pattern multiplied by the field pattern of array of isotropic source, and we are taking the phase pattern of individual source added with the phase pattern of array of isotropic sources. So this is what all about the pattern multiplication. Let me take you through some examples where we are going to take two pattern and we are going to see that how the multiplication of the pattern is all about. So let us see that how the pattern multiplication will be when you take two components and find out the multiplication of those things. So you can make a note of this problem, that is find the total field pattern. So you need to find the total field pattern of two isotropic point sources having distance d is equal to lambda by 2 from each other, and each source field pattern is given by, so one of the pattern is given by E naught is equal to E naught dash sine phi, assume delta is equal to 0. So we can go ahead with finding out how this will be carried out. So we need to find the total field pattern of two isotropic point sources having a distance of separation between them, that is lambda by 2. from each other, and each source field pattern is given by E naught is equal to E naught dash sin phi. Let us assume that delta is equal to 0. So let us see that how this can be carried out. I am going to just go ahead with that. So two isotropic point sources of equal amplitude, and here you can see that two isotropic point sources of equal amplitude and same phase. So I am going to write the equation. It is given that E naught is equal to E naught dash sin phi. So I am going to go with the equation E is equal to E naught 2 E naught cos of psi by 2. And what is psi? Psi is dr cos phi plus delta. So E is equal to 2 E naught cos psi by 2, and psi is dr cos phi plus delta. So let us substitute psi here, and before that we will find out dr and substitute dr. So dr is 2 pi d by lambda, or when you substitute d is equal to lambda by 2, then you get dr is equal to pi. So E is equal to 2 E naught cos of psi by 2, and psi is dr cos phi plus delta, and dr, you know the equation for dr as well. Dr is 2 pi d by lambda. D is given here for us, that is lambda by 2. In the question it is there, D is equal to lambda by 2. Substitute D here. So we get 2 pi lambda by 2 divided by lambda, and you get it as pi. Let us continue by substituting this further. So psi in once you get dr is equal to pi, when you substitute in the equation for psi, you get it as pi dr. In place of dr, you will get it as pi cos phi. So what I have done here is same phase. So same phase, so means delta can be considered as 0. So I have eliminated delta. So what I am going to get, psi is equal to dr cos phi. Dr I got it as pi. So I am going to get psi is equal to pi cos phi. I am going to substitute this in this equation. So I will further get it as E is equal to 2 E naught cos of pi by 2 cos of pi by 2 cos phi. So we got E is equal to 2 E naught cos pi by 2 cos phi, and now we can further go ahead with the next. This is for the isotropic point sources of two isotropic point sources of equal amplitude and same phase. You get it as E is equal to 2 E naught cos pi by 2 cos phi. But in the question we have been given that the field pattern of individual point sources is given as E naught is equal to E naught dash sin phi. So I got two equations, that is E is equal to E naught dash sin phi, and then I can use this equation in the above equation as well. So what you are going to, when you substitute this here, let me substitute E naught at this point. So what I am going to get here is E is equal to 2 E naught dash sin phi. So I have just done the substitution. So I'll get E is equal to 2 E naught dash sin phi cos of pi by 2 cos phi. So we have already understood before as well. We have taken 2 E naught dash is equal to 1. So if I substitute 2 E naught dash is equal to 1, I'll end up with the equation E is equal to sin phi cos of pi by 2 cos phi. So we need to understand that how this can be done further. So we got E is equal to sin phi cos of pi by 2 cos phi. So this portion sin phi is called as the field pattern of first one, and pi by 2 cos pi, you can see that cos of pi by 2 cos pi, it is called as the field pattern of second. So we have to put it in the form of a figure, and we will just see that how the, when you do the pattern multiplication, how the final pattern will get generated for the field E. So final equation what we get here is E is equal to sin phi cos of pi by 2 cos phi. Now we are going to draw for individual field patterns of sin phi as well as cos of pi by 2 cos phi separately, and when you do the multiplication of each, how the pattern is going to be. So let us see that if you take the pattern for the sin phi, so sin phi, the pattern will look in this form. So you can take some values of phi, and you can just plot the pattern. You will get when you plot the pattern, you will get the pattern in this form, and pi cos of pi by 2 cos phi, you will get the pattern in this form. So we have already drawn in the case 1, we have already come across this cos of pi by 2 cos phi, pattern for cos of pi by 2 cos phi in case 1. So you can see that the maximum value will be 90 and 270, and minimum will be in 0, 180 and all. You will be having half power at 60 degrees and all. So so after this we can see that all this can be then further multiplied to get the final pattern. Okay. So this is what the field it is going to get generated, that is, you are going to get the pattern for sin phi, and you are going to also get the pattern for cos of pi by 2 cos phi. So let us see that, as you know that when you multiply the pattern, you can understand that the pattern will get shrinked or it gets expanded. So that is what you are going to see here in this concept. So let us multiply these two pattern, that is sin phi multiplied by cos of pi by 2 cos phi. So try it out, the multiplication of sin phi to the cos of pi by 2 cos phi. So you can take some values and you can draw this pattern, both the pattern, and you have to go with the process of multiplication. So when you do the pattern multiplication, you can see that you might have you can see that the maximum value here it will be 1, okay, and you here also it will be 1, but when you have some values at the half power, and you may have different values here as well as this, you can see that sin phi it will be slightly wider in compared to cos phi, cos of pi by 2 cos phi, so it will be little bit shrinked one. So you can just take an example, like if you are multiplying 5 multiplied by 2, so what is the answer? Or you are going with 5 multiplied by 0.8, so it is going to come further shrinked one. So you are going to take like 5 multiplied by 0.5, you will get it as 2.5. So you are going to shrink the pattern, and you are going to see like 5 multiplied by 2, you are going to expand the pattern. So that is what you are going to see here in the case of pattern multiplication. When, let us see that when it is sin phi multiplied by cos of pi by 2 cos phi, you are going to see that how the pattern is going to get generated. So you are going to narrow down the pattern here, and you will get that E is equal to sin phi cos of pi by 2 cos phi. You will get the narrowed pattern here. So you have to draw the pattern little bit in narrow way, because when you do the multiplication of both the pattern, you're going to get in this form. So the concept is very simple, since it's the same concept of multiplication, and you can understand this. You have to see that whether the pattern is narrowing down or whether it is getting widened by using the multiplication process of the fields. So you can have a note of all those things. Further, I want to just take you through another example. Let us take another example, that is, let E0 is equal to E0 dash cos phi. So when you are going for E is equal to E0 dash cos phi, the equation will be E is equal to 2 E0 dash cos phi cos of pi by 2 cos phi. And when you simplify that further, 2 E0 dash can be taken as 1. So I am reducing it off. So finally, I will end up with cos phi cos of pi by 2 cos phi. So let us try that how the pattern multiplication will look like when you are taken the values for cos phi multiplied by cos of pi by 2 cos phi. You can just draw the pattern and multiply the pattern cos phi with cos of pi by 2 cos phi and check it out how the pattern will look like, whether it is going to widen or it is going to narrow down. All those things we can find out. So make a note of all these things and you can just do that. So with this problem, we'll complete this problem and we'll wind up for today. So all of you can make a note of the second one, that is E is equal to cos of cos pi cos of pi by 2 cos pi. So you draw for cos pi, you draw the pattern for cos pi, also draw the pattern for cos pi by 2 cos pi and multiply the pattern and check how the pattern is going to be. So we need to draw the pattern, we need to take the values and substitute. As you know that you need to find out the maximum values, you need to find out the minimum value, you need to find out the half power points, and then you need to plot the graph for that. So you need to plot the pattern for cos phi. Then after that, you have to also plot for cos of pi by 2 cos phi. See that whether the pattern will get narrowed down or it gets widened. Okay. So I'll take you through the both the patterns of cos phi as well as cos of pi by 2 cos phi. Cos of pi by 2 cos phi we have already drawn, the same one. But in the case of cos phi, the pattern will look in this form. You can see that the maximum values will be in 0 and 180. And you can see that 90 and 270 will have the minimum values. You have to find out the half power points and draw the pattern. So if the pattern is of this type and you go for the multiplication of the pattern, so can you just imagine how the pattern which is going to get generated by the multiplication of these two patterns will be? We will see that how it is going to be. So we have cos phi multiplied by cos of pi by 2 cos phi. So you can see that in case of cos phi, it is maximum is in 0 and 180. But in the case of cos of pi by 2 cos phi, maximum value is in the case of 90 and 270. So it will be very interesting to know that when you do the multiplication of these two things, how the pattern is going to get generated. So we have to see that now because of the atmospheric noise, when the two field patterns of the antenna will overlap each other, so how the pattern will look like. So when it overlaps to each other, you can see that it is both the patterns are having maximum value at different intervals, that is here it is at 0 and 180, here it is at 90 and 270. When they overlap each other, so how it is going to be is in this direction it will be like. So you'll be having the fields in all the four directions. So that is what you'll be getting for cos phi, cos of pi by 2, cos phi. So you'll be having the fields in all the four directions when it is cos phi multiplied by cos of pi by 2, cos phi. So you can make a note of these things. Today we have to summarize, today we have done understood what you mean by pattern multiplication and how the pattern multiplication of two patterns are carried out and what is the equation for that. We have seen all those things. You complete this portion. So we have also seen that when it is sin phi multiplied by cos of pi by 2 cos phi, you have seen that the pattern gets narrowed down, but there the maximum values were there in 90 and 270 in the both the case of both the case, but when it was cos phi sin of pi by 2 cos phi, the maximum values were in the different angles, that is 0 and 180 as well as 90 and 270. So when you overlap or you do the multiplication of the pattern, you find that it will be in the all the four directions. The pattern will be in the all the four directions. So it will look in this form. So these are the things what we have studied today. You complete those all the four patterns. Okay, fine. Today that's what we have to remember, the equation for pattern multiplication. We have to remember what is the process of pattern multiplication, how the pattern multiplication has to be carried out. When you have two pattern, when you multiply, how the final output of the pattern will be, which is having the maximum values in the same direction, that is 90 and 270, both the patterns, then you can see that either it narrows down or it will widen up. But if it is in the other way, you can also, you have also seen that you have the pattern in all the four directions. So this is what we have studied for today. Is that clear for everyone? Is that clear for all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So in the next class, we'll be studying about linear array of n isotropic point sources. So we'll be studying of n isotropic point sources. So that is what we are going to see in the next class. So today with this, I will wind up and we will continue with n isotropic point sources, linear array of n isotropic point sources in the next class. You just go through all this, whatever we have discussed till today, and make a note of all these things. Okay, that's all for today. We will wind up with this. Thank you all. You can just make a note of all those things, whatever we have discussed, and you can leave the meeting. Thank you.